WrestleMania 8 at the Hoosier Dome. Well, I hope you're satisfied. Mudbreaker, what are you trying to do? Wreck a family here?
Monsoon, you and the humanoids last week saw one picture of Elizabeth.
It doesn't mean a thing.
But this week, you're going to see more pictures of Elizabeth and, like she affectionately used to call, Slick Rick. We're going to take another little stroll down memory lane, huh, Elizabeth? Claire has more pictures of Elizabeth than Hugh Hefner has of all the bunnies.
Folks, we're going to get to the bottom of this week. We have a very exclusive interview here with the Macho Man, Randy Savage. How about that?
I would get a good divorce attorney, you know, Marvin Mitchelson. I'd call him direct, because you're going to see today a little blast from the past.
You have a sick mind. Here we go.
You're going to see nothing.
Champions Ted DiBiase, the Million Dollar Man, and IRS Irwin R. Scheister with Jimmy Hart, and Sensational Sherry's Main Squeeze, Shawn Michaels.
Special interview on tap for you. Reigning Intercontinental Champion Rowdy Roddy Piper goes head to head with Bret the Hitman Hart. Here we go down to ringside. I can't wait, Bray, to see what kind of garbage you're gonna lay on us this week.
Well, you're going to see the rest of the story this week.
That's disgusting.
I'll tell you something, Monsoon. Jake the Snake took a chair to the Undertaker. You saw it. He must have hit him 20 times.
At least.
As hard as he could with a metal chair, and it never fazed him.
Well, I wouldn't say it didn't faze him. He knocked him down a couple of times, but he kept getting up.
Got right back up. Got right back up. And at WrestleMania 8, I believe Jake the Snake Roberts is in for more trouble than he's ever realized he could ever be in.
I think you're in the right ballpark.
Hoosier Dome.
It's going to be a happening, WrestleMania 8. 3 weeks away now, folks. If you don't want to be left out, and I know a lot of your friends, Brain, that are going to be left out, because you're going to wait till the last minute, like a lot of folks are out there, and it's going to be too late, and you will not be part of the greatest wrestling extravaganza of all time.
Well, I'm still hoping you come through with those 45 tickets.
I told you to forget about it.
All he's 45 tickets.
45 tickets?
Yes.
Taking care of an orphanage.
Oh, please.
Oh. Awesome power possessed here by the Undertaker.
I hope Jake the Snake is watching.
I'm sure he is.
Look at this. Look at that.
Look at that power. Oh, that's what Jake's going to have to contend with. All kinds of action at WrestleMania 8. You can count on it. Earlier on, we had a chance to talk to the big guy in black.
Snake Roberts, you chose to dance with the devil. Now at WrestleMania, you must face the Reaper.
The Grim Reaper at that.
I'll tell you one thing, Undertaker. Don't ever, ever, ever count Jake the Snake Roberts out. He is the most craftiest individual I've ever seen, and he'll come up with something. If it's going to be a 200-foot-long cobra with four heads like a pit bull, and the power of a locomotive, he'll come up with something.
He lies, just like you do, Brain.
I'm telling you.
Just like Mr. Perfect does, and Ric Flair does.
Undertaker, you
better... I was trying to stir up something.
You better put your dancing shoes on, pal. You might be tangling with the devil yourself.
You better check out your dancing shoes, Brain. You may have to make a hasty retreat out of town.
Put your seatbelt on, because right after this match, you're going to see the rest of the story.
Yeah, more lies, right?
Have you heard from Elizabeth in a week? Did she
say... She's in seclusion. She's probably upset.
Soon.
What's wrong with you?
If she had nothing to do with Claire,
says she'd say so. Wouldn't she? Has she ever lied to you?
No.
Well, then she'd say so.
This one's over, folks.
You aren't kidding.
Looking really good as WrestleMania 8 approaches rapidly, just 3 weeks away.
He's got no eyes. Oh, he's a sick pup.
What a matchup that's going to be at WrestleMania 8 as The Undertaker faces Jake the Snake Roberts. Let's go back and take a look at this awesome human being.
Look at the power here. One hand picks a man up by the throat and just jams him right to the mat. And look at this back suplex. It could be Jake the Snake Roberts. Well, I don't think you'll ever get Jake in that position.
What an awesome individual. Special report time. I can't wait.
Hello, everyone. This week's special report is brought to you by the WWF Fan Club. Now, to find out more about the Fan Club, just pick up a copy of the WWF magazine. WrestleMania 8 is just 3 weeks away. Sunday afternoon, April the 5th, at the Indianapolis Hoosier Dome. Remember, it was in Indianapolis that we heard the blockbuster announcement of the gigantic WrestleMania 8 double main event. The immortal Hulk Hogan to clash with the sociopathic Sid Justice, while flamboyant Ric Flair defends his WWF title against the macho man Randy Savage. Now, when Hulk Hogan travels, you would rather expect to see him on his Harley Davidson Wide Glide. But just look at the Hulkster arriving here in the grand manner, as only the Hulkster could. However, already pervading the atmosphere, one can feel the volcanic pressure building to an explosive force when Hogan meets the maniacal, awesome, and brutal Sid Justice. However, arriving in style is not just the monopoly of the Hulkster, it is also a trademark of the World Wrestling Federation champion Ric Flair. The flamboyant one also arrived in a manner befitting that of a true, high-flying, jet-setting superstar. And while on the subject of Ric Flair, the whole world has been shocked by the scandalous, tasteless, and vulgar allegations made by the champion about the lovely Elizabeth. Recently, my colleague Vincent McMahon tracked down Ric Flair and filed this report.
Just who do you think you are, Ric Flair? You said you had information that was going to inhibit the performance of Randy Savage at WrestleMania. Information is one thing, but the filth, the dirt you dug up last week, that's not designed to adversely affect the performance of another wrestler. That's designed to break up a marriage, to break up a relationship. How dare you, Ric Flair? That kind of information, it's that kind of conduct, it's despicable, certainly unbecoming of someone of your stature as the World Wrestling Federation champion.
What you're seeing here, McMahon, is the arrogance of the World Wrestling Federation champion, the arrogance of a man that knows he's on top of every aspect of life, a man whose word is unreproachable, a man who right now is holding what could be a collector's item by tomorrow. Recognize this magazine? You know why it could be a collector's item by tomorrow? Because Randy Savage is at a fever pace trying to buy every issue on the street. Would you be embarrassed? He's embarrassed. You know why? Because we're revealing the fact that his wife did not lead a life of celibacy. That there was life before Randy. That there was... Well, look at this picture right here. Here we are in her living room, on her sofa, where we spent so many enjoyable hours. Me with my huge arm nestled around her shoulder, watching a program I was no fan of back then. Do you recognize the two people there? Well, that's you and my financial advisor, Bobby Heenan, TNT. Once again, the evidence rolls on. Let's look at another photo right here. Here we are, playing billiards. That's pool to you. Actually, I'm teaching her, as I taught her so many other things. You know, she had a real palatial crib. Right off to the right of this table, you can't see the picture is her bedroom.
We're not gonna talk about that.
Oh, we'll talk about anything I want to. I'm a WWF champion. Have you forgotten? Let's go back to the original scene. Here we are. Let me assure you one thing. McMahon, the temperature in her pool is second to none. But let's look real closely here at the hottest item going. You see those two towels, right? R and L, Rick and Liz. As the story rolls on, McMahon, Randy and Liz, I understand there's a lot of dissension in that marriage right now. Randy, don't be ashamed of that feeling. Nobody can walk in these shoes. And Liz, as that tension builds up, as it starts to really get to you, don't be afraid to drop a dime. You got the number, and I got a big shoulder to rest that head on. And Randy, most importantly of all, as you walk that aisle at WrestleMania 8, as you have to look me eye to eye, remember, Randy, she was mine before she was yours. Woo!
What a down-to-earth guy that Hulkster is, Brain. Pulling up there in that big bus.
Well, he may have come in on the Hound, but he'll be leaving Hoosier Dome.
Not a show-off like your guy.
He'll be leaving flat on his back. Rick's not a show-off. He's the World Wrestling Federation champion. He should be in a limo with Perfect. Huh. But did you notice in the pictures with Rick and Liz, did you notice the towels?
No, I saw the towels.
And an L. See, this was just not one date, Monsoon. They were an item. Don't you believe it now?
Shit. Boy, you guys are sick. At WrestleMania 8, Skinner will face The Rocket. Here he is.
Skinner, let me introduce myself. I am The Rocket, and you may be an expert of fighting crocodiles and alligators and whatever it may be. But when you step in the ring come WrestleMania against me, you're going down. The Rocket is soaring to greater and greater heights. Number one, baby.
Look out, Skinner. Rocket, a very determined individual.
Live World Wrestling Federation action is in Madison Square Garden. 1 week from tomorrow night, on March 23rd, the immortal Hulk Hogan will join forces with the Intercontinental Champion Rowdy Roddy Piper, meeting Sid Justice and WWF Champion Ric Flair. An explosive main event tops the Madison Square Garden WWF card 1 week from tomorrow night.
That is disgusting and humiliating, just like you.
Oh, look at that.
Look out, neckbreaker coming up.
What happens when he spits in the Rocket's eye at WrestleMania?
What's look at that. If the Rocket spit
back.
Oh, let's see some more of this.
We're not going to see any more of that garbage. Any more of that puke. Latest edition of Spotlight Magazine available this Thursday on newsstands everywhere. On the cover, the lovely First Lady of Wrestling, Elizabeth.
It says Elizabeth, her life and her love. I wonder if she has pictures in there with Slick Rick.
Here's what we've been waiting for, Mean Gene with the Macho Man.
Oh, yeah.
Randy Savage, let me first of all thank you for allowing us into your home during a time that has to be very difficult for both Elizabeth and yourself. And I respect the wishes of Elizabeth not wanting to appear on camera at this time. But what about the allegations from Ric Flair? You saw it in front of a nationwide television audience on Entertainment Tonight. I mean, the photographs showing he and your wife at poolside, watching television together, nestled on the couch, even playing billiards. Very intimate situations indeed. And then Ric Flair saying that Elizabeth, well, let me quote him. Randy, he said, she was mine, Randy Savage, before she was yours. I really don't know what to say. You know, the very image of Elizabeth, and then that storybook relationship between you and her, all of this now coming into question. Randy Savage, what are you thinking? Tell me, what are we supposed to think?
And just what are you thinking? What are you thinking?
Well, I mean, there's pictures and a lot of evidence.
Untrue.
Well, these allegations...
Untrue!
Yeah, but Randy, I mean, the photographs at poolside...
Untrue!
Well, I mean, at the billiard table and watching television...
Untrue!
Papa...
Untrue!
It is clear the Macho Man Randy Savage is visibly upset over the accusations made by Ric Flair. Well, 1 week from tomorrow night at Madison Square Garden, the immortal Hulk Hogan and the Intercontinental Champion Rowdy Roddy Piper will have their chance to silence the World Wrestling Federation champion when they take on Ric Flair and the dreaded Sid Justice in the main event. Now, coming up this hour, we will hear from both sides of that incredible matchup. Also, 1 week from tomorrow night, Irwin R. Scheister, one half of the new tag team champions, will go one-on-one with El Matador Tito Santana. Let's get more on that encounter.
IRS, you are flying high. One half of the tag team champion, a new manager of the Mouth of the South, Jimmy Hart. But this is not a tag team match. This is you and I. You're going to find out what the Matador went through to prepare and become an El Matador. I am ready. The training I went through was hard, man, to get me ready for the likes of you. I guarantee you, you're going to know the Matador. Olé!
You know El Matador. The IRS knows that all you are, baby, is a borderline wrestler.
That means adios, amigo. You know what I'm saying? IRS is on you. He knows you're a tax cheat, El Matador. Right. And now it's time to prove it to everybody right here just exactly what kind of cheat you really are. I've heard about you, I've seen your kind, and now it's time for you to pay Irwin R. Scheister. I'm going to get every penny, El Matador.
Irwin R. Scheister set to go one-on-one with El Matador Tito Santana. Also, Skinner, he battles Tatanka.
I'm so excited to be in the World Wrestling Federation, showing my great heritage, the Native American heritage. And not only am I proud, all my people are proud. All over, all the Indian nations combined, which symbolizes the red hair. And also, I'm making my mark in the World Wrestling Federation. And Skinner, you're going to be my stepping stone to rise to the top of the World Wrestling Federation. So you better be ready for the war dance, because I'm coming for you, Skinner.
The Native American to battle it out with the superstar from the Everglades. See it happen 1 week from tomorrow night, March 23rd at Madison Square Garden.
Well, I hope you're satisfied, Brain.
Are you speaking to me?
Yeah, I'm speaking to you. You see how upset the Macho Man was? How disoriented he was?
Hey, everybody's got a past. What's he worried about?
What do you mean, what's he worried about?
It's because Flair was there before he was.
You know, you've made this a very personal issue, Brain. And I don't think that's right.
Oh, I'm sorry to hear that, Monsoon. What if Flair pulls out the pictures of you and Betty Davis?
Will you stop?
You never know what he's got.
Incorporated a little respect around here. After all, we are the tag team champions.
If you had pictures of me and some dog, I would certainly tell you if it was true or not.
What does it mean, Brain? What does it possibly have to do with anything? Other than the fact that you guys are trying to wreck a family, and I think that that's disgusting.
Well, don't tell me about it. I never took the pictures.
Aren't you part of it all?
I'm the financial advisor. That's it.
Oh, please.
Say cheese.
Oh, give me a break. You guys are disgusting. You stoop to an all-time low.
You're going
to
see
somewhere down the road, you're going to have to pay for it.
Hey, you're going to see more pictures next week. And the week after, Flair has volumes of photographs, albums, go war.
Macho Man is a walking time bomb, and you better hope that you don't run into him.
The champ, baby, the champ.
The current reigning WWF Tag Team Champions, Million Dollar Man Ted DiBiase and IRS, will have to face this duo at WrestleMania 8, the Natural Disasters, and they're not happy.
Jerry Hart, you left the Natural Disasters for DiBiase and IRS. At WrestleMania, we're going to take those titles.
That's right, boys. It's payday. WrestleMania 8, and the Natural Disasters have come to collect.
Upset, and rightly so, as they were double-crossed by their manager, Jimmy Hart, who now manages the Million Dollar Man and IRS.
I wouldn't say double-cross, Monsoon. I would say that shrewd business.
Shrewd business?
Yeah, Jimmy wasn't going anywhere with those two big buffoons. Now he's got money. Now he's got the World Wrestling Federation Tag Champions.
Not to change the subject, but where are the original photos, Brain?
The champs, baby, the champs.
You know, I'm from Rochester, New York. I have some good friends at Eastman Kodak, and I'd like to have these things checked out.
Fine. Talk to Flair about it.
Talk to Flair? I'm talking to you about it.
Well, don't talk to me
about it. You relayed a message to that other piece of garbage.
Oh, you just scared that Flair's going to dig up some photos of you.
Me?
You.
He'll never come up with any of those, I'll tell you that.
Because you never had a date.
This one's over. The reigning WWF champions will have to face at WrestleMania 8. Natural disasters could be the end of the road in a hurry for these two champs, as they may turn into be two chumps.
According to the new tag team champions, the Million Dollar Man, Ted DiBiase, and Irwin R. Scheister, their merger has only increased their value here in the World Wrestling Federation. Well, IRS will be on his own 1 week from tomorrow night, March 23rd, when he arrives at Madison Square Garden to take on El Matador Tito Santana. Also in the main event, the Intercontinental Champion Rowdy Roddy Piper will team up with the immortal Hulk Hogan. Together, they face the dreaded Sid Justice and the World Wrestling Federation champion, Ric Flair.
The last time that garden rocked, it's because the big man dumped Hulk Hogan to win the Battle Royal. This time, he wanted Hogan alone. Hogan said, oh no, I gotta have a partner. So the big man got me. So Piper, you and Hogan want us. Remember, Piper, I squash you like a grape. And then we turn Hogan over to the big man.
See, when it's all over, it's going to be you and me.
Just like last time, I won that battle royal fair
and square. Now, you went out and got yourself a partner. Well, I got the best partner known around. And together, we rule the world.
Woo!
You know something, Sid Justice and Ric Flair, with the battle royals, the cowardly acts, all the backstabbing, and the twist of fate on your side, Flair, you're not even figured in after WrestleMania. We're going to make sure about that. But first, we're going to have fun in Madison Square Garden, right where Roddy Piper and Hulk Hogan laid the groundwork for all this insanity. Mothers and dads, the Hulkamaniacs have. Brothers and sisters, they have. But now, Hulkamaniacs, we've got a big brother complex here. The big, mean brother that's gonna watch our back. Get it, Flair?
You see, in the garden, what we got is a problem of bullies. We got Sid Justice, this big, huge idiot, Bumblecope. We got brain like this. We got idiot like this. We got a guy howls and screams, but really meows like a kitty cat. Tyson's gone. Buster Douglas is gone. You're looking for a few good fighters? Get set to sweat. You found them.
The Hulkster and the Hot Scott ready for a war 1 week from tomorrow night at Madison Square Garden. Don't miss it.
Jam-packed here in West Palm.
Quiet, quiet. What are you talking about?
Listen to this music.
What news? Listen.
By his manager, sensational Jerry.
Bimbo.
And
who's singing?
Weighing
Sherry.
35 pounds. But hailing from New Haven, Connecticut. Here is Danny Kamar.
I can't hear.
Listen.
She's been bitten by the love bug.
Color coordinated now.
They're an item.
A big item at that.
Put that camera on.
Boy, is he conceited,
isn't he?
Oh, of course they do.
What do you think El Matador is going to do when he gets in the ring with Michaels?
You get down there and you be.
Gotta give this guy a wrestling lesson. That's what he's going to do. What a nice close up that was.
Is she in love?
Boy, oh boy.
And he knows it. He's got her wrapped around his little finger. It's the way it should be.
Tell you what, she's kind of laid back and subdued of late, don't you think?
You know, he snaps his fingers and she jumps. He's got her trained well.
What a match! matchup it's going to be at the Hoosier Dome, WrestleMania 8, when he gets in there and faces one-on-one El Matador, Tito Santana, a guy who can do it all, Brain, and has proven it.
Well, they're both gifted athletes. They both know what to do in that ring. It'll be a heck of a match.
Ooh. You think that Sean has got the credentials that Tito has? I don't.
Well, he's got one thing going for him, Tito, though.
What's that?
Sherry.
Oh, boy. Earlier on, we had a chance to talk to El Matador, Tito Santana.
Shawn Michaels, you've got a new love, yourself and Sensational Sherry. Enjoy it, because in WrestleMania 8, it's all gonna come to an end. Ole!
A crashing head. Whoa, Scott Allen, hard to the concrete. Oh, look at this, she's gonna get involved. What is she doing?
Whoa!
A tremendous array of WWF superstars will be in Madison Square Garden 1 week from tomorrow night on March 23rd. Superstars such as Shawn Michaels, El Matador Tito Santana, the Nasty Boys, Bret Hitman Hart, and others, including the main event tag team matchup with Ric Flair and Sid Justice, meeting Hulk Hogan and Rowdy Roddy Piper 1 week from tomorrow night, March 23rd. It all happens in Madison Square Garden.
Whoa! Well executed side suplex.
Forget about it. It's over.
You know, talk about love. I wonder if Miss Elizabeth is still in love with Ric Flair.
Why would she be in love with Ric Flair? She's married to the Macho Man.
She may be married on paper, but in her heart, she still cares for Slick Rick.
Oh, boy.
What Flair told me.
How could you possibly know what's in her heart?
Listen to this song.
Michael!
Will you stop? You couldn't carry a tune in a basket.
What, you talking to me?
Yeah, I'm talking to you. Oh, doesn't sound anything like the music.
I got more rhythm than Motown.
Oh. Here's some of the action that went down earlier on. You won't be able to do that to Tito Santana.
You'll be able to do that from the front and the back to Santana.
Well, there he is, getting into his private limousine. I hope they have a good time.
I'm sure they will.
Ladies and gentlemen, Shawn Michaels has left the building.
Who cares whether Shawn Michaels has left the building or not? We'll be right back.
Be part of the greatest WrestleMania ever, live from the Indianapolis Hoosier Dome, headlined by a gigantic double main event. The immortal Hulk Hogan faces gargantuan Sid Justice one-on-one. Then it's double excitement as WWF champion Ric Flair defends his title against Macho Man Randy Savage. Don't miss the bus. Charge your tickets by phone at 317-239-5151 or at any Midwest Ticketmaster. See WrestleMania 8 live Sunday afternoon, April 5th.
And ladies and gentlemen, my guest this week are going to be involved in what I think is going to be one of the great classic matchups as part of that star-studded card at WrestleMania 8. It's going to be for the Intercontinental Champion. First of all, introducing the challenger, Bret the Hitman Hart.
Former Intercontinental Champion.
He wants it back.
Sure real bad.
And has got the tools, as far as I'm concerned, Brain, to do just that. The last thing he wants is to have a match of this importance and not beat a guy in a skirt.
It's called a kilt for your...
Look at that, a picture of Bret Hart, picture of Piper. Friends, question
right
mark.
Now,
I wonder.
From the champion.
Oh, I think they are.
Champion, Rowdy.
They may have mutual respect for each other, but I don't think they care about friendship. He wants to hold on to that gold and... Bret Hart wants to take it. It's that simple. It's business. Matter of business.
Everything is business to you. Dollars and cents.
Yep. Look, he's carrying his skirt now.
Kill. I'm going to tell him what you said.
Roddy Piper, Intercontinental Champion, you are not wearing your kilt this week.
I tell you, first of all, it's always nice to see the folks, and... Only time I wear my kilt is when I'm going to fight. And,
I'll tell you something. I didn't come here to talk about fighting today. Come here, sit down. Come here, sit down. Sit down, sit down.
Bret Hart, if you would, please.
Please, please. Bret, come here and sit down. Sit down. I didn't come here to talk about fighting. Actually, I come here to talk about something the whole world could use is not fighting. It's what I talked about, you know. Bret, I know you, doggone it, man. I know you since you've been about this high, man. I know you. Matter of fact, I might have changed your diapers one time. I'm not positive, man. But I got to tell you, you know, in this fight, April 5th in WrestleMania, I'm going to back out. I'm not fighting there. I'm gonna give this one up. I'm not going to be in the Hoosier Dome. No. Don't give me no booze now back there. Let me explain something here. Let me explain something. You know, wait, please. I'll tell you something. You know, with Bret Hart here, I've known him for years. I know one time, I'll tell you one time, there was about 40 of us wrestlers, man. And we come to Bret Hart's house about 11 o'clock at night, and Bret Hart's mom, she come down in her bathrobe, man. She started making sandwiches faster than submarine could, man. And she fed us all, and she took care of us, and I sent her flowers, and she sent me a card, and I love your mom. I love your mom. Man, you know, I guess if a guy could pick his mama, I'd pick your mama as a mama. I love her, and I can't find it in my heart to go out there and fight you. So I'm not gonna, man. I'm not gonna go to WrestleMania. I'm not gonna fight. I'm just gonna give the bye. Man.
With all due respect, Roddy, you gotta understand, if you don't fight me, that means this belt's mine. That means the Intercontinental Championship's been forfeited. That means this is my belt.
Wait a minute. Hold it, folks. Do we have a new Intercontinental Champion before WrestleMania even starts?
Oh, everybody out of the pool. You shut up, and I don't think you understand what I'm saying to you. What I'm saying to you is you're a real nice man, and you come from a family of legends. And I know they're legends, and I know you fought your way, but I fought my way off the street, out of the gutter. I fight for keeps. Let me tell you to your face, if I'm going to fight you, if you think I'm going to go and shake hands with you April 5th in the Hoosier Dome and be real nice about it, you're full of baloney. If you're that serious about it and you want to fight, then you better shake hands now, because from now till April 6th, I'm going to hate your guts, and I'm going to do everything I can to destroy you. It's your choice. You stick your hand out and shake mine, you've got to fight. If you don't, the nice thing would be, let's let it ride, and let's have a nice friendship.
Somebody do something.
I guess I'll see you April 5th.
Okay. All right, champ. I'll see you April 5th.
All right, Edson Brandon, ladies and gentlemen.
Whoa!
Hey,
oh.
Yeah.
Let's go. You want to go?
Yeah.
We don't need to do that stuff from behind. We can do it right here, right now.
You know what, Bret? I would have had you, Bret. Come April the 5th, Hoosier Dome, I'm playing for keeps, Bret. See you later. But remember, I would have had you, Bret. I would have had you.
What a matchup that's going to be at the Hoosier Dome, WrestleMania 8.
Everyone, your WrestleMania report brought to you by Nintendo Super WrestleMania. Now you too can go head to head with the World Wrestling Federation's greatest superstars. Look at these guys working it out. We are 3 weeks out and counting down to WrestleMania 8 at the Hoosier Dome in Indianapolis, Sunday afternoon, April the 5th. By the way, tickets are going fast, so make plans now to join us for this extravaganza. That includes a gigantic double main event. World Wrestling Federation champion, Ric Flair, to meet challenger Macho Man Randy Savage. We heard from these men earlier on in the hour. I personally talked to Savage. I get the feeling there is so much anger pent up in this man. I don't know whether or not he can focus or concentrate on his objectives of regaining the World Wrestling Federation title from Ric Flair at WrestleMania 8. The other half of that gigantic double main event, the immortal Hulk Hogan, to meet a crazed and volatile Sid Justice. Let's get comments from these two men.
Hogan, you wanted him, you got him.
It's 3 weeks away. Imagine you're sitting there, Hogan, with a feeling in your gut like somebody just stomped a hole in it. You know what that feeling is? It's fear. It's fear that you know that you now have to be the man that you say that you are. You have to prove to the world that you're not a coward. You have to face me one-on-one. I finally get my chance to put my hands around your throat, and I'm going to lift you up, and I'm going to drive you into the ground, and you'll look up at me, and you'll say, Sid, you rule the world. You know something, maniacs, when I think about 3 weeks away, brothers, it's like an eternity. It's like forever and a day. Because this is the day that wrestling like Hulkamania either lives forever or it's all downhill. You know something? Yet, Sid Justice, we don't know if you're a man or a mouse. We don't know if you're a redwood tree that you possess to be that can stand the test of time. Or if you're like the cowardly lion, Wendigo, the stump of my tail. You know something, Sid Justice? Everything you've done since you've got in the WWF has been a cowardly act, brother. Thank God the hierarchy at the Titan Tower on Exit 9 have finally got behind Hulk Hogan. Because if you didn't go with the Four Commandments this time, wrestling, your job, your lifestyle, the WWF, it's all over, man. Sid Justice, Hulk Hogan's gonna pay you a visit at WrestleMania. And what you gonna do when Hulk Hogan, the Maniacs, and the whole WWF run wild on you?
Obviously, Hulk Hogan is ready for Sid Justice at WrestleMania 8. Just signed a gigantic 8-man tag. On one side, the Big Boss Man, Virgil, Sergeant Slaughter, and Hacksaw Jim Duggan. The opposing foursome comprised of the Nasty Boys, the Mountie, and the Repo Man. According to the discussion I had earlier on, that intercontinental title bout between champion Rowdy Roddy Piper and challenger Bret the Hitman Hart should be something else. More titles on the line. A mandatory title defense for the brand new World Wrestling Federation Tag Team Champions, Million Dollar Man, IRS with manager Jimmy Hart. Oh, did he sell out? To meet the natural disasters, Earthquake and Typhoon. The Undertaker, one-on-one, his opponent standing by with comments. Let's hear from Jake the Snake Roberts.
Why are we so different? What makes you tick? What makes me tick? Who really cares? A lot of questions need to be answered. Maybe WrestleMania 8 will find out some answers to those questions. One question in a lot of people's mind is, why didn't I make a big target right in your forehead and nail you, big man, when I had the chance? Well, I'll tell you something. There's some things even I won't do. Clubbing baby seals is one. But I'll tell you something about them. When they're flopping around the ice and somebody walks up with a hammer and they drop that hammer on their head and they crush their little stinking skulls, why? They're doing a job. Well, that's what I'm going to do. I'm going to do the job in Indianapolis on you. Why? Because I've got to. For survival. And after what I owe you, man, you ruined my party. Remember, I had the chair up ready to crack Elizabeth, and you ruined the party.
An awful lot of evil in that man's eyes. More action one-on-one. El Matador, Tito Santana, to meet Shawn Michaels. Michaels will be accompanied by Sensational Sherry. One-on-one, the British Bulldog to meet the Berserker. Native American Tatanka to meet the model Rick Martel. And the Rocket Owen Hart to square off against Skinner. You know, it has become a tradition because kicking it off at WrestleMania this year, singing the national anthem, it's the golden voice of country great Reba McEntire. I can hardly wait.
Oh, rumor has it.
It's so easy to join us. You can charge tickets worldwide by calling 317-239-5151. In the Midwest, tickets available at all Ticketmaster locations or at the Hoosier Dome box office. Ladies and gentlemen, 72,500 expected to be on hand for this extravaganza. Make your plans to join us right now for Sunday afternoon, April the 5th at the Hoosier Dome in Indianapolis. It's WrestleMania 8.
The following contest.
I can't wait for April 5th, Brain.
It's going to be something, isn't it? Oh.
Currently in the ring.
I wonder which corner Elizabeth will stand in.
Here is.
What do you mean, which
Kato.
Corner Elizabeth will stand in? Hit the deck, Indians!
Will you stop?
And his opponent.
Well, you never know.
Weighing at 265 pounds, I'm hailing from Pembroke.
Keep your mouth shut, Brain. No one would know how stupid you are.
Oh, they know.
Well, I guess they would. A real Native American, Tatanka, headed for the Hoosier Dome. His opponent, the model Rick Martel. Red hair, of course, signifying the unification of all the nations.
Well, I thought it was a salute to Lucille Ball.
It is not.
Just a wild guess.
Woof. I think Hot Rod tried to pull a fast one there, Brent.
No, he was just sending a message to Bret Hart that if he wanted to, he could have taken him out. What he meant was, don't turn your back.
I mean,
don't
earlier on in the interview, he thought that by taking the bye, he would still remain the champion and hold on to the title.
Well, see, that's Piper's biggest trouble in his life. He thinks, and he can't do it.
Earlier on, we had a chance to talk to the man with real arrogance, the model.
Tatanka, remember Wounded Knee? When I'm through with you at WrestleMania, you'll remember Wounded Head and Broken Back.
Catchy, I like that.
I like that. Yep, you would. You're sick. You're a sick person. Oh, there it is! Elevator down! It's over. Is he ready? He is.
Here is your winner.
Duck, the flaming arrow just went by.
Oh, boy. It had your name on it, I hope. Tomahawk chop being done here in West Palm Beach. Here we go.
But Kato up on his back, and like you said, just dumps him. Bounces right back up.
Tatanka looking forward to WrestleMania 8. Here we go to the event center.
1 week from tomorrow night, Tatanka will be far from his homeland, but the massive superstar claims he will travel any distance to spread his message. He arrives at Madison Square Garden to take on Skinner one-on-one Monday night, March 23rd. Also in a six-man tag team battle, the Nasty Boys and the Mountie. They will collide with the Bushwhackers, Luke and Butch, and Bret the Hitman Hart.
Wow!
Yeah!
And the Nasty Boys want to get down and they want to get funky with the Hitman and the Bushwhackers. Wow. So come on, boys, because we are ready, right, team?
Oh, we better be so ready, Hitman, and the Hitman's got us all fired up and all into each other. Look, isn't it great? And we ain't going to be known as the Bushwhackers. We got to be the Heart Whackers. Yay!
Hitman, it's going to be a brawl. Yay!
Tell him! Oh, you're in a lot of trouble, Bret Hart. You're in a lot of trouble, Bushwhacker.
That's right, Bushwhackers. Yeah. Bret Hart, it's as clear as day. You're on our ladder on the way up. The Nasty Boys and the Mountie are stepping over you like little bushwhacking nobodies. You're going through Nastyville on the way.
I like it. I could see, Bret Hart, that you made some new friends since I beat you for that Intercontinental title.
Listen up. There ain't gonna be any friends, Bushwhackers and Bret Hart. There ain't no Yayin and Wallen and Nasty Bell. We're coming to fight, baby. You better bring everything you got, 'cause you're gonna get nasty sized.
According to Jimmy Hart, the Bushwhackers, Luke and Butch, and Bret the Hitman Hart are going to regret their trip to New York City after this six-man tag team battle with the Nasty Boys and the Mountie. It all happens 1 week from tomorrow night. Also at the Garden, Virgil goes one-on-one with Shawn Michaels, who seems to gain more confidence with each outing. El Matador, Tito Santana collides with one half of the new tag team champions, IRS. We just heard from both sides of this six-man tag team encounter. It's the Nasty Boys, Knobs and Sags, and the Mountie facing Bret the Hitman Hart and the Bushwhackers. And Sid Justice will join forces with World Wrestling Federation champion Ric Flair to take on Rowdy Roddy Piper, the Intercontinental title holder, and Hulk Hogan. See it all 1 week from tomorrow night, Monday evening, March 23rd at Madison Square Garden.
Promotional consideration paid for by the following.
Cobra's back, and this time it's personal. Who can stop them? G.I. Joe!
The accent's bigger than ever. G.I. Joe, Esau Sibley.
Joe! Hulk Hogan Vitamins!
Yay! Hulk Hogan Vitamins, the new champion of children's chewables. You've got my name on it.
The WWF ring is all action! Punish your opponent with drop kicks! The WWF ring ropes have spring action for furious flying tackles! The WWF ring comes with flag and championship belt!
Charge into the ring with WWF Super WrestleMania for the Super NES, Hulk Hogan, Sid Justice, and other WWF superstars. Go toe-to-toe in 16-bit singles and tag team action.
Cobra's back, and this time it's personal. Who can stop them?
G.I. Joe! American Hero!
The accent's bigger than ever. G.I. Joe, Esau Sibley.
Joe!
Big lineup headed our way next week here on Wrestling Challenge. The Big Boss Man will be on hand, along with a very dangerous individual, Sid Justice. Also to join us, Bret the Hitman Hart.
And next week, also Monsoon right here, will be the WWF champion, Ric Flair, with even more damaging evidence about his relationship with Elizabeth.
What do you mean damaging evidence?
Good day.
So long, everybody.